decided to try to play the way I normally play DDO, which, you know, I do solo a lot, but I have music in the background, so this is just a test to see if it'll work. I don't know if I'm going to go with this format permanently, but I do like to have music when I'm questing. And my music varies. Right now I've got Bobby Brown playing, you know, I'm a child of the 80s, you know, a lot of my music developed back in the 80s, you know, it was just so much good music back then, and it was all over the place. I listened to rock and pop and boy bands like New Edition and, of course, you know, artists like Michael Jackson and stuff. So I'm just collecting quests for Questless Island, which we'll be going out to today. And I know I said I was gonna do this in the afternoon, but unfortunately for me, I woke up at 6 this morning and I have energy, so I figured I might as well get this playthrough done so that I can be off of Questless Island. I love what they did with this new player area, but the sooner I can get like really into how versatile a warlock is, the better. So getting the experience I need so that I can enjoy the class is key. Now, new players, this is a very awesome thing that you can do. 5 turbine points, you probably got that doing these first couple of quests. You buy this bottle of grog, and then you give it to this dude, and you get a res cake. I mean, you can't beat that. And just in case you die, which dying happens, you know, unless you're on a hardcore server, and I've got 2 of them because they gave away a free cake a few weeks ago, just for being VIP, so. Alright, so we've talked to everybody out here that had a chalice, which is what you should do if you're new and you're trying to figure out what you've got to do next. Look for people with chalices over their head, and once they're no longer gold, they'll look like this. If they're blue, it means you've done the quest already. And they have little arrows to people that you should talk to, so that helps as well. And I do this a bit different than some people. A lot of people will go in and they will immediately run to the first quest that you dive off to get to. I am going to instead go and get the Caneth crystal thing done, because it's a rather quick quest, and I feel like it can be done before that. We're still going to pick up the quest out here in Porto, so anything that's on the way, which means this dude standing on the cliff right here. And like I said, you know, streaming really does lag my system out, which kind of sucks, you know. But I am hoping that eventually I will get to a point where I can stream this game, play music, and enjoy things. And like I said, you're going to hear a lot of 80s tunes today because it seems like that's what my playlist wants to go to. And right now the Bangles are rocking. And it's perfect. It's lining up. I'm running around this wintry landscape. And I'm in full Ice Princess mode. And my Hirelings are kicking butt. And the sky is a hazy shade of winter. I promise I will not sing a lot, y'all. This is just me having fun this early morning. completely show my age. I warn people all the time that I'm an old lady. Maybe some of y'all will believe it now. You know, every once in a while I get, oh, I've seen your picture, Kalari. You do not look that old. Well, thank you, dear, but I am. And I'm at that age where it's impolite to ask a lady. And see, yesterday I had to play music on my phone and have my earbuds in, but I felt like I was talking really weird doing that. And when I play DDO, most of the time, even when I'm in group, I have music going. Like our Sunday static group, because I can still hear everybody on Push to Talk, I have my music playing in the background. It just helps me focus, it's fun, and it's... I thought I turned this DM voice off. Oh well. Hopefully it's not too loud. I know I turned it down completely. There's a lot of remixes on this playlist too, I love it. Jump Jump really isn't 80s though. I think that Criss Cross came out in the late 90s? Uh-oh, server restart. Okay, well, we'll be able to get a couple of these quests done before they take the server down for a restart. 30 minutes shouldn't take. That's nothing. So, we're in this Caniff Manor factory, and if you're new, you're probably like, why is she running around here like this? Well, we're basically trying to find Laws Heaton. He is, like, I guess, a founder or whatnot, and he knows what's going on in Korthos. And all of this is just a story, you know, that leads to how Korthos Island is being used as a hub by these evil cultists to, I don't know, summon a dragon god or something? It's all crazy, but it is fun to see how much they changed the beginning of this area. It wasn't as intricate before. So we may not get Misery's Peak done because that quest by itself is, ugh. Alright, see that? That's a trap. It's on the lead as well, so it would hurt if you went through it. You can guide the dog through it, and sometimes they take a lot of damage. And sometimes your hirelings give no Fs and they go through it, and you really don't want that on Elite. They really do hurt. Having a rogue with skills will not only get the traps down, but get you a little bit of extra XP. And then you can go safely through here. There's another trap. And you just come around here. If you have rogue skills, you search, or you have your rogue search for them. And then you take the trap down. Or you try to get them. Sometimes the higher ones can be too brave. Alright, but we're going to go back around here because there's a little bit of XP this way. Avoid the poison. Now, most people should have the search skills for this. It doesn't take much. As an elf, you get bonuses to your spot and everything anyway, naturally. It's like they almost try to tell you they want you to do stealthy and searchy rolls. And you get a little bit of XP for stopping the poison. I mean, it's not completely necessary if you've got the trap person to get the traps down, but why not? Why not get as much XP as you can? You know, I do this because the more you reincarnate, the more XP you do need. So, of course, you want to go for ransack, and that means you break everything, you fight as much as you can, though there are some neat quests where you can get a boost if you don't kill a bunch of stuff. So I do like that it varies. And I should try to go faster, because they are going to do a reset in 30 minutes. But I do want to show the optionals in this quest, so we're going to hoof it. And it's going to be more Iron Doggies. And I normally like Iron Doggies. I have an Artificer for our Vi. I haven't played her in a while. She's been reincarnated a couple of times too. She used to be a wizard. So if you go through this door and you have a robe, you can have them or yourself pick the lock. Of course, they are Iron Defenders guarded, and they will grease the area if you stand there too long. So you're gonna want to quickly get in that door, because they will start making things slippery and not in a fun way. Oh, Rob Zombie. My playlist is all over the place. But yeah, we are going to loot. Not a bad great axe. I wish I had the barb in the party that was actually not an NPC. Could pass that on to them. And like I said, I have very, very taste in music, so you will hear just about everything during these playthroughs. If this works out, I'm gonna listen to the playback of this video after I'm done and see if it works. If it does, now I went back here not because of this line, but because if you don't have a robe, you can hit this valve and it'll open the door to this room. That's coming up. And this room is important because you have to take down these crystals. But what you don't want to do, and you can have a rogue pick this up, is run across these icy jets. They will kill you. It is on a lead especially, and it does really massive cold damage. So what you want to do is sneak around, get under here, and hit the valves. Now, and it'll indicate to you that you're doing the right thing. But you want to be careful. Some of these players that have been playing for a while, they just run right through these things. And they don't take a lot of damage because they have built-in immunities and stuff. And even I, you know, I just took 5 points of damage. I'm lucky. I have cold resistance because of being a cold warlock. But a player that's new, that doesn't have any kind of built-up resistance, these traps will kill you. So, especially for new players who are on the hardcore server, we're seeing these messages, death from misadventure at level 2, and it's because of quests like this where people don't understand, you know, resistance. Like, I get natural resistance from shift buffs, and then, you know, being a cool warlock, I have resistance from that, so you just want to be careful. And now I'm going to let the hirelings loose so that we can destroy these crystals. Oh, the valves are not all turned. Holy crap. What valve is missing? There's a rogue. We'll have him handle that. I see where it is, never mind. I thought I got you all. That was not blocked, come on. DDO, you're testing my patience. Maybe if I got it from this side. There we go. It did not take them long. Alright, this next part is a pain in the butt because It's kind of babysitting, but not really. Hopefully we'll hit the bad guys hard enough to where Hayden doesn't need me nannying. You know, normally I would have, like, a healer keep focused on Hayden. But, I mean, we should do enough damage to the stupid Schwagen to where he should stay safe. I don't really have buffs for him either. So, this should be, interesting. What you can do is set your fighters up around here. Byron right here. Virgil. Or, okay, Delgan, you're Eagler. Two over there. And then Virgil right there. And that should be enough coverage. And you go talk to Lars and start this up. Like I said, my music's all over the place. I listen to a lot of indie, a lot of pop, a lot of music. Come on, auto targets up. Select the allies. Like I said, the best thing to do is just try to get these things down as fast as possible, and they won't hit Lars, and you don't have to worry about failing the quest. Because it's a pain in the butt trying to babysit NPCs, especially since they won't stay out of the fight. Come on. You know, and in an unprepared group, he will take a lot of damage. And then you have to do it over. And that sucks. He talks really brave for a guy who's like, oh no, just walking. Come on, next wave. Ooh, well, Malgun took a lot of damage. That's the life of a bodyguard. Sucks to be you, guy. Come on. Watch where you're swinging that axe, buddy. Come on. This is the longest part, waiting for these waves to come up. Get that orange name down as quick as possible. That. Alright. So you talk to him, and one of the funniest things, you know, a lot of us rip and run through these quests. You don't pay attention, you will recall out before it's finished, so just wait a bit. Don't even open the treasure chest until after. I always do that so that I remind myself that there's a delay between finishing the quest and actually getting out. And of course, I'm getting a whole bunch of combustive things. It's like that on the hardcore server too. I play Ice Wizard, I get combustive. I play Fire, I get glaciated stuff. DDO gods are cursing me. But, yeah, I probably wanted to do a longer playthrough today, and I may come back after reviewing the video, especially if the music works. I can maybe even do a few solo hardcore runs with Kalari so you can see what an ice warlock at level 10 plus is. She's almost level 13, actually. I've been banking on that server so that I can get as much favor as possible for the Celestial Mount. But if this video sounds good, which I'm going to get ready to go back and review since the servers are coming down for a restart anyway, you'll probably see me later on this afternoon, either on Hardcore or back on here, trying to get through Korthos. And I'm just taking whatever. I'm not going to use any of this stuff. I already have a Feather Fallen cloak. But hopefully this was enjoyable. I am enjoying streaming. I just, like I said, I have to get used to it. It's a new world for me, and hopefully we'll get through it together. But I'm going to wrap this up for now. Let them take the servers down. Maybe go make some morning tea and make sure my son didn't completely wreck my kitchen making breakfast. So hopefully talk to y'all soon.